Good morning. Half a day. The Committee on General Government Operation Appropriation and Housing is now called to order. Today is Wednesday, May 10th, and the time now is 9:03. Notice for this public hearing were disseminated via email to all senators and all main media broadcasting outlets. Public notice and change was issued on Tuesday, March 2nd, and then on Monday, March 8th, and today's March 10th, 9:03. The committee will hear and accept testimonies on my colleagues and to the people of Guam. We have three bills to hear today. We have Bill 56-36, 7-36, and 60-36. And after consulting with the authors of the other two bills, I asked for their indulgence that we would proceed with Bill 60 first. And that was introduced by Senator Telo, co-sponsored by Speaker Therese M. Terlaje, Senator Joanne Brown, Senator Sabina Perez, Senator Frank Blas, Senator Tony Atta, myself, Senator Chris Dueñas, Senator Telena Nelson, and Senator Jim Moylan. And that's an act to amend Section 403H of Title I, Guam Code Annotated, relative to changing the official name of the municipality of INARAJAN to its name in the Chamorro language, namely INALÅHAN. I'd like to acknowledge the senators that have joined me this morning. I have Senator Chris, I have the author of the bill, Senator Telo, Senator Chris Dueñas, Senator Tony Atta, and Senator Jim Moylan. I know I have, we have one more senator that was here, I probably stepped out. But moving along, the conduct of this public hearing shall be as follows. Those testifying on behalf of Bill 60-36 LS will be recognized by myself and invited to the panel. We do have them on the panel this morning. We have former Congressman Delegate Robert Underwood, Mr. Ken Chargloff, Mr. Victor Dueñas, and the mayor of INARAJAN, Tony Chargloff. Written testimony shall be submitted to the committee. Please provide my legislative staff with your written testimony for photocopying. Testimony may be read, and lengthy testimony should be summarized to about 5 minutes, but we'll allow additional time as required. Individual will be allowed to present oral testimony only once, and once you're done, you may be asked to remain in the room for questions or for additional testimony, as may be desired by members of the committee. Question and testimony shall be confined to the substance or nature of the agenda. Personal inference as to the character or the motive of any senator or any individuals testifying is not permitted. Any violation of the general rule of conduct will result in removal from the public hearing. Proper form and decorum shall be practiced by all present in the public hearing room for this proceedings. Individuals who fail to maintain proper form and decorum may be restricted from providing oral testimony or may be asked to leave or asked to leave the room. When you speak, please make sure that the microphone is on and that you speak into the microphone. Please state your name and your title for the record. Also like to also recognize Madam Speaker is also present. Senator Peter Terlaje is also present. I would ask the author of the bill to please make her or her opening statement. Thank you, Senator Telo.
Sijus Masi, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity. Bill 60-36 LS, an act to amend 403H of Title I Guam Code Annotated, relative to changing the official name of the municipality of INARAJAN to its name in Chamorro language, namely INALÅHAN. Sponsored by myself, and I'd like to thank my colleagues, Speaker Therese Terlaje, Senator Joanne Brown, Senator Sabina Perez, Senator Frank Blas, Senator V. Anthony Atta, Senator Joseph Augustine, Senator Chris Dueñas, Senator Telena Nelson, and Senator James Moylan for supporting this legislation. And half a day to those who are here testifying today, and to Duas Masi for joining me. Mr. Chair, at the request of INALÅHAN, INALÅHAN Municipal Council, Bill 60 was introduced, recognizing the village of INARAJAN by its name in Chamorro language, namely INALÅHAN. Mr. Chair, I was pleased to learn prior to their introducing Bill 60 that the Commission Ifino Chamorro is working to adopt Chamorro names for all villages. I look forward to supporting other bills that may be introduced to officiate the village name changes into local law. I did have an opportunity, Mr. Chair, to speak with Mayor of Malesu, C. Ernest Chargaloff, who supports this legislation. He wasn't able to make it today due to a family funeral. But he too, I'm working with as well with regards to the change of Mariso to Malesu. Also speaking with Humatec, Imatek's mayor, to changing that to Humatec, as well as Agat to Hagat, these areas in the south. Mr. Chair, I've also received testimony from Judy Flores, as well as Joseph Cameron and William Polino. Unfortunately, they were not able to be here, but you could read their testimony. And it will be available on the website once the committee report is done to review them. Mr. Chair, while this legislation may seem like a simple policy proposal, I believe Bill 60 will help to gradually reshape the lens through which our children and young adults identify with our Chamorro history, language, and culture. In testimony submitted to Senators on Public Law 24-152, which changed the name of Guam's capital city from Agaña to Hagatña, language experts and University of Guam students at the time offered their support for efforts aimed at preserving Chamorro language. Ms. Tina Delisle stated that the bill renaming Agaña to Hagatña was part of a necessary effort to immerse people into the Chamorro culture and was vital to preservation of the culture. Mr. Robert Cruz said the legislation was a good start toward exposing the Chamorro language in an effort to preserve it. Ms. Therese Babauta suggested that legislation be introduced to change the name of other villages to their proper names in Chamorro. Dr. Catherine Uggen, who in 1998 was involved with the Chamorro Heritage Institute Planning Group, wrote that decades of colonial administration and the imposition of foreign ideas and concepts have nearly obliterated our heritage and identity as people. Dr. Uggen added that we have had to rediscover ourselves, our thoughts and ideas, and perhaps someday we could restore all that we have lost. Mr. Chair, although ideas such as Bill 60 may not restore all that we have lost, I'm confident now, more than I have ever been, that when a community is seeking to be recognized in our native tongue, the impact of this bill will be much more than changing the name of a village on paper. Sujus Masi, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Telo. We will now begin receiving testimony. We'll begin in the order they signed up. Coincidentally, the mayor ends up being last, which is perfect, because then the mayor will be able to speak for the on behalf of the people of INARAJAN, INALÅHAN. Mr. Underwood, sir, would you begin, and you'll be followed by Mr. Chargaloff, then Mr. Dueñas, and then the mayor.
Okay, thank you. Buenos dias todos, Hamzo. It's an honor and a privilege to be here before you, Chairman San Agustin, Speaker Terlaje, members of the committee. First of all, I want to say Biba Nalahan. Todos ya manatango Biba Nalahan. I want them to know these are, well, he used to be my student. So, just like Senator Telo there. So I'm very pleased to be in front of all of you today. My name is Robert Underwood, and I'm a member of the Comisión Ifino Chamorro, more elaborately known as the Commission on the Chamorro Language and Teaching of History and Culture of the Indigenous People of Guam. This morning, I'm presenting testimony on behalf of the Comisión, which is chaired by former Senator Hope Cristobal. I'm presenting testimony on Bill 6036, which is to rename, for official purposes, the village of INARAJAN as INALÅHAN. Of course, the Commission supports this very worthwhile idea, but I will also use this opportunity to explain what the responsibilities of the Commission are. By law, the Commission is also known as the Commission INALÅHAN, or the Place Names Commission. Under this law, the Commission is enjoined to provide a coherent, culturally sound, and historically accurate set of criteria for selecting place names. In keeping with this responsibility, the Commission is to coordinate with a number of agencies and in turn, those agencies are required to consult with the Commission. In addition, the Commission is required to, quote, study ancient Chamorro terminology and pronunciation of place names and restore affirmation pronunciation with the current Chamorro orthography. The proposed bill does that, but the question that is, I think, is before us is really whether the legislature will be involved in all place naming or whether it will leave it to the Commission to carry out its duties in an orderly, coherent fashion. The Commission recently passed its Magat Plano, or Master Plan, 2 months ago. This includes an extensive place naming process, which will involve consultation with the mayors and informants on place names, whom the mayors themselves will refer. The Commission intends on taking village names first over the course of the next 3 months, divided into southern villages, central villages, and northern villages, and then and pass the appropriate spelling after due consideration and certainly public hearings on the matter. As we can all appreciate, we anticipate that there may be areas of disagreement, and there will be strongly held feelings about certain place names. The Commission has been entrusted to navigate this process. We will do so willingly and in full view of the public. We understand that as a result of this review, there may be disagreements which may end up back here in the legislature. But we ask you to treat us like you would the Zoning Commission on their zoning decisions, that you do so only carefully and judiciously. While I fully understand the authority of the legislature, the Commission requests that you allow us to manage this process, which will be time-consuming, involving considerable research and consensus building. The village names themselves are not likely to be contentious. I think most people support Humatak, Malesu, Hagat, and Talofofo, spelled in accordance with their Chamorro pronunciation. The words will look startling to some upon first view, as in S.San, where there are clearly two S's. But I think most people will accept it over time as they have come to appreciate and accept Hagatnya, as outlined by Senator Taitague. There will be contentious conversations over renaming a place like Agania Heights as Tutuhan, as some have suggested. As many of you know, Tamuning is not a Chamorro place name, but it certainly has deep historical roots because of the presence of the Carolinian, Igapalo, Irrefalawash, and Guam, who used to live in Apotguan. Beyond villages, there will be avid conversations on whether to keep Jonestown or Perezville or Barragata Heights and search out the original place names. But finding the original place names themselves may not be all that easy and will require the research of older documents and the application of tools like GIS and even GPS. Moreover, it is uncertain that the public will be enthusiastic about that. The last significant responsibility involves the process going forward. The Commission will negotiate a role in the Guam Land Use Commission to approve or encourage the use of Chamorro place names in upcoming planned unit developments. In this, Guam has allowed places like Kaiser and Baza Gardens to enter the place name lexicon. I can say that with some assurance that there will be a lobby for BG, the BG boys, and maybe even for Gura 501 or No Downtown. I know because I used to live in Baza Gardens, and I now live in Jonestown. But we certainly should do something looking forward before all existing place names are forgotten. The names are rich, meaningful, and intrinsically valuable. As you can tell, this will not be an easy process. We anticipate working on all the villages within the next 3 months and all existing place names over the following 3 months. At the same time, we will be working with all of the agencies and working with the Guam Land Use Commission. I love INALÅHAN, Malesu, and Humatak. But Maledzuk has been thrown aside for Windward Hills. Maybe there are enough people who want Camp Witik to survive. But it also begs the question, what happened to Camp Watkins and Camp Dealey? We need a coherent and consistent process which supports traditional names. It can happen and has happened. I don't think more than 25% of the population of Guam in the mid-1990s ever heard of Tidjan. It is now fully accepted, thanks to the Tidjan Reuse Authority, and is even used in naming Tidjan or Abdomen High School. Who would have said, let's name a high school after your Tidjan? It would have been unthinkable. Well, maybe Dagan, I don't know. The question is whether you will allow us to do this. If the legislature is inclined to enter in all of these controversies and in effect overrule what will happen in the future, then I believe the commission deserves to know. Debido na claro kumalago hamzo na intatiji ilay dani intention niya si tus maasi ginin Jonestown.
Pues
Perez bill.
Fino imanom ko pues bueno, Mr. Chugloff, sir.
Buenas dan saludos, Senador Joe San Agustin, Chairperson of General Government Operations, Appropriations, and Housing, Senador Telo Taitague, INALÅHAN, author of Bill 6036, dan todos, Senador Imana 36 na Legislaturang Guahan, manana si Zeus dan hafaday todos samzo. Thank you for giving the people of INALÅHAN the opportunity to support the renaming of our village from the Western pronunciation of INARAJAN to its indigenous and traditional name of INALÅHAN. Guahu si Kenneth P. Chugloff, INALÅHANZU, desde Imafinagu, Estapalco, na momento. I am here this morning in full support of Bill 6036 to rename INARAJAN to its indigenous tomorrow name of INALÅHAN. As a native son of INALÅHAN, I grew up speaking our native Chamorro tongue, and my parents always referred to our village as INALÅHAN. When I am asked, which village am I from? I always responded, Tauto INALÅHANZU, not Tauto INARAJANZU. Historically, we refer to our village as Sung San Jose Gize INALÅHAN. My siblings, Todi Toto Iseng Sung San Jose, knew the name of our village as INALÅHAN, not INARAJAN. That's my identity growing up in our beautiful, peaceful, historic village of INALÅHAN. The word INALÅHAN is part of me, and it is intrinsic and deep rooted in my heart. It is who I am, and I get emotionally moved in identifying myself as the native son of Sung Sung INALÅHAN. Somehow between history and Guam today, we allow outside forces to dictate and influence the rapid changing of our traditions, culture, and the erosion of our language, including the pronunciation of our villages throughout our island. Honorable senators, thank you for collaboratively working with us in a collective effort by sharing the same values to start restoring our traditional beliefs and culture for generations to come. Thank you for Bill 6036 to give us back our identity as the proud people of INALÅHAN. Si Zeus Maase, and I pray for a quick passage and support of Bill 6036. Guahu si Kenneth P. Chugloff.
Zeus Maase, bueno, Mr. Dueñas.
Village INALÅHAN gi Pun San Jose nagumadzugos. Uagwadesi sinidot ang ginimpegas di halong gikurason nizo don nafaluffan hulu gi magahaga zo fitma in sigida das sa fefektu na anya I village inalahan inalahan ti inarahan mago jo anginin tu laika zon funa sa jo zon juti ge alom tangkim basula zon na annok inalahan jabem fam bani dosu na tatau inalahan sama pega tati ina amnya ni perfecto na an inalahan I inalahan si jus maasi ja predia I mane e kungo kwena hujung agang I sinido ni jo jon jau I intisonia jon sopoti jo ma puna sa ji inalahan jo ma pega tati original na an inalahan senador am jo ne cinco Por favor, fanyao no holum, junna kabolis, esti ingagagaw ni tatao na lahan, jun fan aajuda, pogo na momento, ufafay sinam jugi olum kurason nijo, por favor, fanyao no holum, bunga mamasa, sa angi mamatuan ju papa gi distriktun inalahan, bay honor hamju, nan sopoti esti ibiu, 60-36. Si Jus maasi, ja si Jus todo amju genoulu, fambinindisi jan todo itatautano. Adios.
Jus maasi, Mr. Dueñas. Now for the Honorable Mayor, Mr. Chargloff. Sir?
Offer the Honorable Senator Jose San Agustin, Chairperson by Senate Committee, General Government Operations, Appropriations, and Housing. Honorable Senator Telo, or Senadora Telo T. Taitague, I Gumelului, Jatumugi, Estin Nabil, I said, Senta 36. Dan todo amjun, Honorable Senador, dan Senadora, Ginigi, Mina. Then I size na legislature and Guam undang klu na sidus masi ni na isti na putni dat para by na yam du testimonio to support the supporting isti na bill. My name is Anthony P. Chargloff, a resident of Inalan for 53 years and also the current mayor of our beautiful village. As a child growing up, I would always hear the word Inalahan from our manumkos when they speak in our Chamorro language, referencing our village. I would see signs within the village proper that read Inarajan around the village stores, the schools, on letterheads, t-shirts, and banners, but it never quite bothered me then. As a parent, it became obvious that the younger generation were not speaking the language as often as I did, and I take full responsibility for not affording my daughters the same opportunity my parents and grandparents provided me in exercising my native language growing up. As a parent and now as a mayor, I am witnessing the slow and yet progressive decline amongst our people practicing the Chamorro language. It has now become the responsibility of this generation to keep this language and culture alive. Changing the name from Inarajan to Inalahan may not be significant to many, but it is significant to those who are trying to sustain and perpetuate our culture, our Chamorro tradition. And I applaud all the various groups, both locally and nationally, for their efforts in trying to revive and maintain our Chamorro individuality. Inalan has been labeled a historic village, and to embrace and make that true, our village should be properly addressed with its historic name of Inalahan. When a language and culture dies, we lose perspectives, ideas, opinions. More importantly, we lose our identity as a people. The little but significant things we do, such as the adoption of Inalan as opposed to Inarajan, will ensure that our culture and language remains alive and flourishing for generations to come. Malaguzu looking about Now I am doing dunklu na si Jus Masi, no este na putinidad, ipen ekungok, itatago siya ni presenta siya pago, no este ibiu senta 26. Dunklu na si Jus Masi, mucho mas hagu Senador, senadora Telo Taitague ni una posible este pago na bio. Si Dios masi tolu samzo.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to also recognize that attached to his testimony is approximately 120 signatures that signed the petition in support of the change of the name. And I have asked the mayor if we can get a copy of a resolution from the MPC, and he has agreed to obtain that and then provide that to the committee's report. All right, sir. We will begin. We do have four other individuals to testify, but we'll begin questions of my colleagues here, and we'll begin with Speaker. Speaker Terlaje, do you have any questions to the panel?
No questions. Just wanted to say, Sisus Masi, for being here and for testifying, and Biba Inalahan.
We'll begin with Imasamko. Senator Pido, binako now.
Gavzadala si Zonu, sumangan na guwa masamko, zonggan magahit. First off, I just want to give thanks to the panel for their testimony this morning, and I want to also congratulate the sponsor of the bill for introducing Bill 6036. And let me just say, Mr. Chair, that I fully support this bill, and that I don't know if we're going to change Jonah to Yona. But whatever, like what the president of the former president of the University of Guam had mentioned about the commission, be assured, my dear people, that I will support the direction of the commission, and we're gonna probably depend on the commission because they do have the names. I would think, and we will support the recommendation of the commission. And like I said, we will support whatever input that comes our way in as far as naming several of the districts or the areas on our island. I'm in full support of that. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Senator Moylan, do you have any questions for the panel?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you, panel. Very informative presentation. I appreciate the history aspect of this. It makes me very proud to be a resident and being a public servant, especially. So thank you so much for the presentation. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Senator Dueñas, do you have any questions? I'm going to try to save Senator Telo towards the end. Senator Dueñas.
Jesus Masi, no, you maga sustain a kumuntia, but I give you tomorrow. It's the best tomorrow. Magufo naman na para si Senador Telo Taitague nam na yuju opportunidad pata na co-sponsor it's the nalai. Sa magufo loki hanuli si Congressman Underwood kung todo si Ken Sagalov dani primo si Victor Dueñas dani mayo Sagalov. Ekwa ko hamzo todo untungo esti los si tatao Ricardo Camatsun Dueñas, no, I si tatao lion Jose Castro Dueñas. The I familian Jose Castro Dueñas, tau tau inalahan. Whereas, no, gana bay na ma no ma questiono tau tau ganang hudzong like na si Chris, hadzi no, hafa I zomo no family name, y Dueñas. Like ko ay, si tatao like na ahi tadza lo. Unga angin malago itu na untungu manu gagiau, sengani na gagi itu tau tau inalahan. Sa untungu apa na anuli I familia guana man ogang tongku. Sa sengani na I roots gi tongku inalahan. Pes todu I branches na manggagi gi todu otro village. Pes edzu na duenya sao. Pues jau loke no malago ta da no be supporte este na lai da ungan kon todo gua na hobinzu taza na unekno in a rahan si ta tau ning na ni malak in a lahan da kon todo no I otro oportunidad si telu na matsotsu gi gif pago village na no guy todi I tomorrow kada summer ma hire zi pamagoon lunchun gandi bas mago for loku and a hobinzu matzu and lahan za only lunchun gandi za ai na bunito bas si jus masi no maga sestina kumatia for the opportunity to support the estina lai
jus masi senator Dueñas, senator Ada.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. To our panelists, thank you for your testimony. Congressman Underwood, your testimony here, and I agree with my colleague, Senator Pito Terlaje. Hopefully in the future we can work together with the commission in moving forward on the issues that you brought before the panel here. And otherwise, you know, I look forward to supporting this legislation once the bill hits the session floor, and I ask that the chairman go ahead and move it on to our next session agenda. But thank you all for being here and to testify for this bill. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
All right. Thank you, Senator. Senator Brown, do you, thank you for joining us. Would you like to ask any questions of the panel?
Thank you very much, Madam, Mr. Chairman, and certainly thank you to all of our residents that have come from INARAJAN to testify in favor of this bill, and certainly always a pleasure to listen to our good congressman, president of the university, and of course the list goes on of all his various titles, but I always enjoy how you add humor. But you also send a very direct message and do it in a very diplomatic way. So thank you very much for your comments. You know, Senator Telo is such a force of nature. It's hard to get in her way. And I don't think any of us are gonna get in her way with regards to her passion and her roots in the village of INARAJAN and all that come before us. I mean, while we have some challenging issues, as you know, we deal with in the legislature these days, it's not often we get to deal with bills that kind of remind us of our history and our roots and where we've come from, and go back and appreciate that and see the evolution of our pride in our own selves and our own history. You know, where so much of that was taken away, and we always thought that being westernized and coming from America, as I call it, because I got a number of my own Chamorro cousins who live in America, and America is home to them. I like the resurgence. I like the sense of pride and the sense of history that comes, because I think with all that's ahead of us, you know, we have to hold on to our roots, as Senator Chris mentioned, even though I know he's using it to describe where his family and the roots of where his family is from. You know, it's important. And we have sometimes a tendency to forget that. And I think the younger generation that's coming up in a time of tremendous privilege that our parents and our grandparents never had here, take it for granted. They take a lot for granted. So things like this, and I defer, I certainly appreciate Dr. Underwood, your position with the commission. I think it's a hope that the commission will continue and assume its responsibility. I think we're gonna vote for this bill anyway. Simply because I know the prime sponsor is so passionate about it. But you're right. I think the commission has the capability and the knowledge of how to move forward with the history of Guam and properly naming our locations. Some may be controversial, but we're all a product of a very mixed history, good and bad. But you know, I think those things will always find their way where they need to go. It's like water. It'll find its path. So with that, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Certainly thank you to Senator Telo for expressing her heart and her passion on this issue. We certainly look forward to the upcoming celebrations, Mayor, in INARAJAN. And thank you for coming and testifying and expressing your views and representing the interests and concerns of your residents. I hope this continues the resurgence throughout the other villages. And we just need to have a sense of pride in who we are. I mean, in doing that, we'll always have a good compass. With that, Mr. Chairman, thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Brown. Senator Telo, do you have any questions of the panel before I close the panel?
Yes, I do. Thank you, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity, and Donkalu Sutus Masi to the mayor for being here and putting out all these the petitions, you know, following a process that I thought that was very important. And just for the listening audience, when I was approached to introduce this legislation, it was important to get the, you know, the consensus of the village, people who, the residents of INALÅHAN, if they supported something like this. And it, you know, to many people, it was just a no-brainer, and to others, it was they were very passionate and wanting to move forward. So I know that the list of individuals who signed this petition will continue to grow as well. as we move forward. And I think that the chairman is also anticipating the resolution from the municipal council, which I know is forthcoming, that's already in writing. And when they approached me to do this, there was a celebration that's coming up, actually. We were kind of late in introducing this legislation since we've been working on it since February, the beginning of February, because we wanted to reach the celebration of St. Joseph in INALÅHAN, which will celebrate 380 years of the village. So this was going to be very, you know, important that this legislation get through in time for that. But unfortunately, we're going to miss that because we wanted to follow the process. We wanted to get the input from the village. However, we can still make the deadline for the INALÅHAN Fiesta coming up in May, which is considered to be one of the best fiestas on the island. Okay, so I'm a little biased here, but, you know, I mean, hence the song INALÅHAN from Kalapana. And it was based on a fiesta that day that they wrote because they came to my grandmother's house, you know, and that's where that song came up. But, you know, I truly respect the commission. In fact, I was in the legislature when we supported this organization, the commission, to be put in place to do things such like this. And like most things, you know, Congressman Underwood, President Underwood, and my vice principal of GW, Mr. Underwood, can you tell me if the spelling is correct in your opinion? Is the spelling that we have here, INALAHAN, correct?
This is no longer a matter of opinion. It's a matter, does it consistent with the orthography? That, I'm glad you asked that question. It is. And so the question that, you know, occurs to me, just so that everyone understands the position. We are required to pass an orthography, a spelling system. We did. Then we're required to restore to the extent possible original place names in accordance with that spelling system. So when that comes out, Sinahanya is going to look different. Asan is going to look different. Dededo is going to look different. Jotnya is going to look different. It'll still be said Jotnya and it'll still be Sinanya, but it'll look different. So the question is, you know, we're following the law. And my concern is that someone who is unhappy with that will then turn around and come back to the legislature and overrule that. If that is in the cards, then that will mean that the work is not really, you know, that we weren't really being serious, and that's my main concern. So the spelling that you have in there with a back A dotted A over the last A is absolutely correct. So, and of course, the commission is in general favor of this anyways. Thank you.
And the commission is in favor of it, for the record. Thank you so much,
I'll hasten to add that the commission can meet next week and approve this, and it can be official even before you're able to pass the law.
Yeah, it can be approved, but still by law, it needs to be changed. So that's what legislation will do. By law, we would still have to, even though the commission supports it and it passes the commission, we still have to, by legislation, change it by law.
Okay, well, this is the question I have. Is that really necessary? Because the place name, you look at chapter 88 of the code, and the place name responsibility is pretty broad. It says there, we'll change the names of places in accordance with Chamorro pronunciation and the orthography. I think that's pretty clear. So if the commission is authorized to do that, and someone is unhappy with the result of that process, or does it have to be passed by the legislature anyways? This is a question. It's the same thing that Kenny here asked me before the hearing. The Board of Education is responsible for school names. So does the Board of Education now have to change it to INALÅHAN Elementary School? Or Can they continue to insist that it be INARAJAN? See, those are questions that I think can be resolved, but they just, I just need to put it in front of you so that you understand the appropriate roles. So in looking for analogies to what the role of the commission is, the only analogy I can think of is zoning. The Guam Land Use Commission has authority over zoning until somebody in the legislature decides to spot zone. Now, most people, if you ask members going into the Guam legislature when they're running for office, are you in favor of spot zoning? No, we're not in favor of spot zoning. But then when they get there, all of a sudden, somebody is loud enough, they're in favor of spot zoning. And so, but in this instance, of course, Senator, we have a confluence of ideas. We're all in support of this. So let's just make it happen. But I just wanted to point that out. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Robert Underwood, Congressman. I really appreciate that analogy. And I'm actually going to get with the oversight chair in this area to discuss, to ensure that whatever that question is be answered, or to, you know, make it complete, you know, on your role. Exact role. So thank you so much, Mr. Chair, and looking forward to the remaining testimony for this evening. And to Deuce Mossy, Mr. Chargalov, for being here, Mr. Duenas, Buenas, my primos, I greatly appreciate being here, and you had me, you know, tearing up just listening to your testimony. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Telo. Madam Speaker, you had one alibi?
I just wanted to offer that, I do believe, as Dr. Underwood has said, that we are all in agreement and that there are ways that this can all be, you know, reconciled while recognizing the authority of the commission to advise and, restore place names. We do have laws that lay out what the names of these villages are. That's what we're trying to amend here, and we're going to have to amend the laws, of course, by legislation. We also have what might look like conflicting authorities or consistent authorities with other entities who are authorized by law to dictate the names, for example, of education facilities. And so, I hope that they will do as, that we will all just act consistently, seek the advice of the commission, seek their input, seek everything that they have to offer, and where necessary, change those by law, where necessary for other entities to act, that they also act consistently. And so I recognize the authority of the commission, but I do believe that in this particular case, changing it by statute is consistent with all of that. And so, Cesar Masita.
Okay, thank you, Madam Speaker. And to the panel, thank you, Congressman Underwood. Only words I have for the commission, mungo pumausoa, pangkalamtin, let's get it going. That's my only statement, that's one. Number two, to Mr. Ken, Victor, and to the mayor. When I got into the police department, first area I covered was the South. My grandfather was the chief of police, St. Augustine, so I know many of the folks in the South know my family and they know me. I hung around INARAJAN a lot. INARAJAN. Back then it was INARAJAN. I didn't ever, INARAJAN is when I looked at the name and I'm like, don't even sound right. There's no music to it. And INARAJAN, Guacanta. Number two, St. Joseph. Hey, the name, okay? We can work with this. Number three, when Senator Telo came to me and she said, Senator Joe, will you support this? Your wife is a Chargalov. Her father is from INARAJAN. So you know you got my support. There's no doubt about that. That's an easy one. And I'm trying to think of everything else I wanted to say about it, but you know what? I'm in full support of this bill. We're going to move along on this bill. This bill will be ready as fast as I can get it ready for session, so we can end it. And as any issues come up with the commission and they wanted us to support them, we'll do what we need to do to get it done. And if the names don't fit some of the villages, oh well. We move along and we figure it out. If that's the Chamorro, ne, ampa tinigi Chamorro, pues tu que ne, tatana claro.
Ang gwa problema pasta decide na afa na pamonit mo na. Mungin mo mas kusa why we're not moving forward. Let's just do what we need to do. Because I know, I live in Jigo, I used to live in Derdu, my grandparents are from Agani Heights, but all the families from the south. There's mana na ita tafamali. Let's just fix this and move on. Not make the excuses. Senator Telo, one alibi, and then we're going to move to the next group.
Thank you. Just a real quick to Dr. Robert Underwood. Melesu Humatak and I think Hoggett, those three are already starting a process within their village. So I asked the commission to, because during a interview that was done on the PDN, I think, or the Post, you mentioned that it may take about a year before the commission can go through the names. So I'm asking if the commission, like you just mentioned, it may take just a couple weeks, you know, to prove a name or the correct spelling. So please look at those three other southern villages that are already in the process because they too want their name changed as well. Okay, thank you. I appreciate if you could look into that.
Thank you. And
I
like,
could I respond?
Yes,
to that?
Mr. Congressman.
I mentioned that it would take a year to complete a whole naming process for all place names, not the village names. The village names are already pretty simple because the orthography has already been written for them. And you can sometimes you'll see some older signs that were put up by GVB, and that spelling is pretty consistent with the orthography. But the whole idea of all these individual place names. And here's just another analogy that I'd like to offer, is that people who make official maps for Guam is the USGS. The USGS is the one that does the official mapping for Guam. The USGS secures input from a wide variety of sources. Most of the time, it's federal agencies that give them these names, unless you bring it directly to their attention. And so, as I did with Hagatnya, even though Hagatnya was passed here in the Guam legislature, when I was in Washington, I had to bring it directly to the attention of USGS before it was put on the map. So please understand that there's a kind of competing histories on this. If the commission is allowed to do its work, we can become the contact for USGS, and they're willing to do that because they don't want to engage in any kind of arguments either. So they will comply, and as they do with the state of Hawaii. So the state of Hawaii, for all of us, most of us are experienced with the state of Hawaii. The state of Hawaii is pretty insistent on maintaining Hawaiian names for places. And some of them are tongue twisters, but they don't care because they made a commitment. And so that is the original commitment made in that amendment to the law in 2017. It's in Chapter 88. So thank you very much. But I appreciate that.
All right, thank you. And I'd like to thank the panel. Biba nalohan. I'd ask my staff to, after they sanitize the table, to ask Mr. Dominic Sablon, Benny Sinicholas, and Judy Flores to please have them enter after they sanitize the table.
I think we've got the panel now. Ms. Flores will be back shortly. We'll begin with Mr. Benny Sinicras. Oh, wait. I want to make sure the system is turned on. Are we good? Okay, we're good now. The committee has now returned from a very brief recess for sanitation purposes. We will begin and continue on Bill 60-36. And we ask Mr. Benny Sinicras, followed by Mr. Mantonona, and then Judy, and then Senor Ben Meno, sir. Mr. Sinicras, sir.
Si Jus Masi, senadoras, then senadoros, or senadots. Dispensa de guardi nazi que no gitresna o adredre samtune. Lo magufo pagna matto sanno bonito est in bio e 60-36. In anno pure for record si Benny Paulino San Nicolas toto in Alejandro. The magufo nagayo gini da pabe supportes din bio ipo matulaika e nanya e inarahan para inalahan si jus masi todos os amjo senadores dan senador ni me sponsors din bio gosmali ke sti para itauto inalahan matulaika tatti por favor e original nanya e inalahan. Tadi sekima fanya mau buju loki nai estif ya uhungo gimana nahu dan iman omku ma mangi quintus fiu ama sangan pod inalahan lo uno gi manrebu na pamaguon i millennium gua ha ma kamin gi nigatnya lignya gi da wow hafan para matulaikan anya I inarahan pa inalahan ko often on ko presiso no pues unga na ja ujo jo lokwe na sa isti hebin na na tauto disti ki mafanya ogu lok eja ohumo I inarahan lo dinanches ti na na tana bira tapti ki na anya pa ogu mentar ba gachan satta para ta chogwes ti pes ena ma be samanya mjuno senador dan senadores na si jus masi ni estiza bosmali gestiza u sapopote estina bio I pamatlaika nanya I inalahan tatti ge jainalahan si jus masi da unga nu mangya jo nu written na in kyar sakausu nu tisina sumau ga jo wasya utupa bai chogli dapat bayu nu lo mamatina sa jo no written testimony. Si Jus Masi, todo samdu da si Jus Infinuin Nendisi, da Gus Banidusu, da Gus Magufu Sauli, todo du loke isti se agas manatumoo ni Mansinidor dan Mansinidora, disti ki anti di Mansinidor o Mansinidora amdu utungu amdu da unu utungu man maulik amdu todo du na tau-tau dan pagu ki man senador amju dan senador gaigi kumpen sakku ki damduna champion chegi maulik sa todu pare tau to gwa si dus ma se no da si dus in pambin indisi.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Mantononia, sir.
This.
Ganon.
Hafidi. Since it's tomorrow month, Hafidi Senyot, Senoria. And senadoru and senador, no? Hungan sabat tu pahalum pu fatatsunga yuzum pu sa esta todu ma sengani ni pitinia mi pitiu loki ni putana klarus ti pagui putat telaike naan tu pu mensona if you know English ta sa like what it says tomorrow month mungau ma funu English pu amzu ni ata funu tomorrow pes tana chloros ti pagu papa gi e sengsung mami tato enalanu and it's a pogo, Uhunga got to the Pamalu Ginesta Malangus told the night is like put a song and a summer song and told you put an than a chloro, I see pogo and than a that the like I see pogo, sa ungan perfect two pogo nine, a mess, no? That's a little breasty pogo, give it tomorrow. In Alahan, Sing Sung in Alahan. Pesungan, Magufu, ma Kambira, Mongi, put a, you know, put a support testi in a bill. And, you know, they could Melikna Mungai, that Sonic, at a Faisin Anthony, as the Mizu, you know, Estin at Mess, that's a little brand, if you know, tomorrow, no? Pes sita puta magu puresti bio mami papa gi sing sung in alan na pu favor in papa sin amzu nei you know tana cloro pagu pi tato tonu na sing sung in alahan na man tato you know tato manteno na chargla paulino mahungo gezu pagu sing sung in alan na matunga sta oggi todi familia papa gi gi sing sung mami in alan Pesu jus masih talu, and jenah matu magi loki putas spoti culusya papa gini gi inalan, ay sengsung inalan, okay? Su jus masih talu, and esta talu fanan esta en Chile gatu gi maga pelan, na I biu no na sempi sita talu pufit mah, pesta tenangga talu naya na puta ali talu puta na suguru na kloru todu no.
Thank you, sir. Ms. Judy.
Buenas no hamzu todo ni man honorable na senador and senadora magufu so ali huli ina uno dos tres cuatro cinco seis siete otso nas otso. Hamzu, man mafatu, zahu gofat redesi. Tauto in ala hamzu, disti onsi onyo sedatu. Zano anema kumbida zu parabai quintus guini, magufo. No, disti ki diki kizu, zahu adzik fumino tomoro. No, Lalaksi di palabras in alahan gi ila itauto. Lalaksi bonito. And fumino English na mudung I inarajan. Ti dumansi ne zen I inalahan gi fino tomoro. Edzi gi uno. I otro no. Hagasa no guaha no kumeke legna I inalahan gi palabras na palabras gi fino tomoro. Ina ma ina I at dau sa gaigiam gi san katan na banda za man ina ham kada ogan I bonito na at dau pes ina. Pesi I otro lazan no kumeke lekne na abundancia mege pes inalahan kumeke lekne na bula mege na inina para I sengsung mami pes no dosa edzo lo I pumalo masangan magaitni gini ni korosan niya. Pes edzo no parabe sanganiam zu na hu gof support tiesti da no uno atalo na bai aluk biba in alahan.
Thank you. Senor, Mr. Meno.
Ku saludam tu todo, especial menti sisinidora Telo Taitague, dan todo samju dan Senyor Telaje, predikador, inaanmu gifinut samoro, Madam Speaker. I'm gonna be bilingual. Sa guha tau-tau ta, utungo na tia kumprendi, si Senador Moylan todo ipalabra ni para baisangan, law itrestimonyo gaigi gimenan mizo. Hafa aday dan saludo, manana si Dios. Manana si Dios, kumikiling niya good morning, guha wadu fumatinas. Dagos bagubdo na matatidi. Senador Telaje predikador jam para todo senadora dan senador hafanielos my dear people maniluho my brothers and my sisters who gagaw i attention mido sa hugot sa puti esti na pahana ibil hagas di hutanga hagagas mas di 30 anos di hu pitsigi na para matulay ka inaan isengsong sa tidinanti sa timan tau-tau inarajan ng tau-tau inalahan. Pabay na tungwa amdu. Dos anos na tempo mumuam dan itendang Korean jaleng niya, Mr. Menu. The big sign up there on my store and the, across the swimming pool in Inarajan, Michael, that's not the name. Then the real name, as you enter the village, you will see the real name, the spelling, INALAHAN. Then but we're following the law. The kungan, law pataligaw na tanadinansi. Guahu si Ben Vicente Carlos Menu tau-tau inalan sanhada. Gof magudu para baigay gigwini sumupoti ihagas matanga ni isengsung tau-tau inalahan para umana dinanci tunas inaan inalahan. Unana ihamdu todu dangkulu na agresimento pun esti na minsahi. Ipisyat minti sinidora tenu Taitague hagan inalahan. Si Zeus maasi, tenangga sa kakaya do. Imatunan inalahan, hafa matunan inalahan. Hasangan esta si Zeus. Si Zeus di palo, jabay totsi, finani na inalahan. Ina kumikiling niya gifinut sa moro, kandit, fraslay, metsa, dangis, ang ginunsonggin ay patun na panila. Sa gining kakatan iat daw, ha iinahalom inalahan. Hafa ha iinahalom, bulap ha iina. Itaw-taw niya kantidahin na lahan 2,273 ilirihon niya inalahan katoliko majuriya. Siyati na tolay, otso na sardok, gaigi igima antigo inalahan majuriya. Inalahan tubutuhon gimit 947 si Pali Monsignor Oscar Calvo i-raffle ticket ani queenship contest. Inalahan tubutuhon. Inalahan i-anay mapraktitika i-finut sa moro, i-kultura dan ilingguahi. Inalahan guida uniko guahasagan umomak the swimming pool anong tasi at duha. Inalahan na igayi guinigi isla in terit mundo imas dangkulo na gwalo. Fangwaluan. Inalahan at mas amku na gimaduus. Gimaduus ang gusto ya gos bonito. Ya mga na paraniyagay no, gos bonito. Igimaduus niya sa gusto. Ya inalahan likido interimente. Nagimaduus gay kiliuus gi ekso. Ano mahalong-mahalong gising yung unli edo na. Signifikasyon niya ado na kiluus. Mahat sa igimaduur. Mit 800 1860. Tres 41 anyo esta igimaduus i edad niya. Iminsahi bini nai anigi matunaw niya inalan. Ja iwat timo, tutungo kwanto ki jahamdu. I don't know how many of you. Babay fanu iamdu. Kwanto ki jahamdu. Kwanto ki jahamdu lumi esti manna ni kulut ping. Pumarentis dan China, Xi Jinping. Telo para Agustin. Estigi binahanya inalan bula bula Japania lu senida an mangintusit na ibini ki filu chamoru sa mes chamoru ekwetura ilingwahi ipalabra debi di taadahi hafata sasangan sa tapanana gi famaguon tagi sanidong Jajanggil lah si palabramu mahoka adu. Jahi ti babay fambut leya. Lau debi di tanak dinanti adu siya mga kanta sa bula, mga kanta dot, yang kanta dora zaman sembun itu. Jahu supoti. Lau ipalabra ni mana sensitbi. Lachi. Hafa kumikiliku, hafa na fundamento adu. Gangkululu na fandanggu da ay inobya ni nobyo na buninita magagunya dang ilahi da duro ibaila dang todo la untungo apa problemanya bula na neng kanu bonito to di fandanggu i problemanya timangi ibokan. I'm talking about the quality and the quantity. Edunay na kada uno gizahamdu sinidot dan sinidora attitude. Attitude dan na siguro na hafa in haso, hafa in sangan, hafa para intrislada gi publiko na siguro na tiu pineralisa. Undi kiki na patgun, patilamudung, san man ma e kungo kam tu. I love you, Mr. Moylan, because I always watch you on the TV and you're fighting for us and all of you. Sir, you. Ana hu aatan your character. Ipigo the way you say things. Ipalabra ni angin unsot tahudung. Kau taigihi imilak. You know, the river, dururuutan. The Senator Telo Taitague, I know you don't know that, and none of you know that. And I'm going to go over to Mrs. Flores. Judy, the name of the, our bay, Gizay Nalaan. Kwanto gizam do tumungo? Untungo? Inaanya aduna bikana, the bay, the word bay, bikana given to tomorrow. Inaanya aduna bikana inalahan, lugaan, hafana lugaan, sa anay tiyampun usan, ihanum harukohi gisabana, hulo gisabana. Zanai estatisinya isabana manteni. Hana mila kudung todu para ibikana. Zamuta haluga, luga meaning to peel it out. Aduna iman amku iman yainahu. Sinanang kandilaria at santo di Leong Guerrero idanaw. Ida ko gedmada Rita. Dead gado na putileng niya ni dataman manok kalidok sa ilugaan hatsuda igrasyan Diyos. Put sinidora dan sinidot dan kuludyo agradesi timpun midu jahu angoku na esti na pahana iparamatulay ka inaani sengsong sen magubdo gos magubdo dan kuluna agradesimento Jaga pinitiu paguna ani, jaga paguna ani, jaga kunu anniversary kami ansi. Difuntu Munsine David kita ga paguna ani. Umahan untuk magi para islatura gini. Hatot biu gini batu. Last year. Tumunu kikaritanya dialeknya nuguawai dan naminagudu. Sa hagutot pile ko ha? Ito komprendiya pa kumikiling niya. Lenya ay din na minagudu sa hagutot pile ko ha? Kukomprendi fundamental niya na hatpudya tungo udu na. Tailang niya adwa apasli pabay kadudutyo. Thank you, Munsine. Hatot pila hadamag ikaritaw. Pagunaan ni gini. Gimme nan isti. Law tau dao ga. Pues inalohan. Gang kuludu di magugyo. Nahamdu ni manggagay gigini. Especial menti iman matu gini na sinidot. Tibay malepa. Tibay malepa dang gin mano du. Para i orang botasyon. Hadi matu da. Huli matanya si Pido. Moylan. Di Telaje si San Agustin, di Telo, di Dueñas, buka di giftung aja tu. Tiada. Estigi inaina gos important ti esti i presenti i gaigi tu gini dan gaigi si Mrs. Flores, Signora Flores. Para intingo na sempre ipudet ni hukakat ga itinengo usempi by husiera da by party ujung. My presence here will be shared. I will share this. Di kuminida na matudu gini paguna ani idia des des di matsu. Namunga ihagahu dan ilahihu nieta bisnietu dan taratari nieta. The grandchildren is what I'm saying. Ni hidata juda aduna si didot sa adzigi muna ihit. Ni maulik food mart. Justifikaw. Sincero inimit di pinasentia ginibli'i dan ginaida. Iwati mo. Inalahana na igaigi esti. The courtship of marriage, gifinu tomorrow. Amaga-amaga hudung data afana, kau guahugwagwa tu uhagun mamala lengnya i, tau-tau ilahi, ay palaan. Alak ni magi, etagwaot, paranggasta etapot tabaran harum, etabangku dan pampatatung etacupa dan mamaon, purra gifinu tomorrow. Jahudi sesia na uno kita hamdu. Sinya umaduda pada ta implantas ti. Gagis tigi University Guam. Purura fino samaru. Guahu. Dan sikani. Iprimahu. Tumugi. Todu duesti. I how you get married. Of taimanho umasaga. Antistati. disti itempun madelan estai presenti. Estabe. Pus jangging gua ha interesmu. We need to put this for real. Si Mrs. Flores sumaunawa agin. Remember this, Judy? And I give you so much credit. So she's one of the mover. Uno gi para guini gi na isla gi day na lahan. Este na palan. Sumaunaw guini. Si Tony La Morena, yung mommy director, punasu. Pues manilu, senador, don senadora. At matudo magi guini sa para put pinli ido para from the nga esta para bay matay I'm gonna go 80 law ipuntok ko guini the generation my generation my island mga malepa don't forget mga malepa ni nalahan every one of you should hold inalahan dearly in your heart Zonya, cecitunjan inalahan. Tamuning, cecitunjan inalahan. Andi sunzigu, cecitunjan inalahan. Humatak hagat santarita barigada mangilaw un isla. Tisinya na paran aluk sa sesto tahungo ganaw. We always hear this, ha? Ogu tau-tau, haja gau tau-tau hilu, problema. These are the issues that we face today. Fanag wi fa maguunta, para magwaiza, iisla, isengsung, masaya ginin mamanuhaw. Buenos dias, saludo, manana si Dios, agradecimiento si Jesus maasi. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senor Meno, Mr. Meno. Speaker Terlaje, do you have any questions to the remaining panels?
No questions, just wanted to say si Jesus maasi talo. Dr. Flores, si Tun Ben Meno, si Jesus maasi. We're very proud to be part of this to restore the name, the formal name of, or the record name, in our laws, so that it is consistent with the knowledge and the feelings of the people of Inalahan. Sidus Masi.
Thank you, Senator Peter Terlaje.
Anticipated two and a half para baysangan down on I by nai dunklo na Sidus Masi si Ben Mas and si Mrs. Flores. Dan todo I manano gini man testigo put esti na bio I 6036. Dasta baysangan us baysapot testi na bio da pwedia ta da laki direksyon I komisyon ni pofan matulay ka sa inaan da benfangaygi todo ni kinsi da bensapoti direksyon ni mafatinas di komisyon da bei sangna na gagi ki correction mami na in ekungu kamzu pago ja leliku na sempi ma supportis teni todu ikin sina na mangatsongu Jesus Marcy Mrs. Flores and Ben Jesus Marcy sir.
Thank you Senator Moylan.
Thank you Mr. Chair. Thank you Mr. Menno for your compassionate presentation. I felt your heart and everything that you shared with us and I truly appreciate what you the knowledge that you share and the history that you keep and continue to do so. Thank you, Mr. Menno. Dr. Flores, I appreciate all your work, I do see the beauty that you can capture with your art, so much so that my condominium is full of all your artwork on my walls. Maybe one day we can take a picture with you standing there next to it, that will be honorable. I appreciate that. Thank you again for your presentations. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Brown.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I don't have any questions, but certainly thank you to Dr. Flores and to Mr. Menno for coming and expressing your heart with regards to your roots in INARAJAN and in our island, and reminding us of our need to have pride in who we are and where we come from. So thank you very much for your testimony this morning.
Senator Dueñas.
Si Dios más italo, no imagas estina cometía. No si Dios más y loco para senadora, doctor Flores, dan si tun ben meno. Ya está, pero faisen si tun ben meno, no. Cogagion matatsungi cometía comisión. Siempre ha, sa, hago más tadung sa, un tungo y antiguo, na ilanguejita, sa, Zaulai, Zamagufo, ano no nekunukau, pues engengwa zoku no autoridad para bem matatsunga gena.
Ni do. Si dun ma si ne no. Pa gwa gi egan na man mi meeting am tadik gi gwa mjung sa one of the board of director. Si Agun, Dr. Agun gumehilulu estifinu samoro todo. Jale ku hafa na ti mataka todo iseng tunggu dulu ni adi man praktiku dan iman tekna dan iman fadi gini kita no taleng nya ti malagu atau gueno. I'm talking about the people like me, not particularly me. You don't have to take me. Now come to me and I'll tell you all that I got all the listing of the Chamorro words that you don't, nobody know. But they don't want it, because they want the credit. I don't care about credit. You know where I want credit? Adulu, not here. Will you, Senator, look into that? Touch the community. Reach out. Humartak INALÅHAN zonya, Malestro, Santa Rita, Mangilo, Barigada, Andizun, Afagumas. Gwagwahaha. Man amku man lalala, and I'm one of that. Thank you.
See you, Smasi, Tana.
Senator Ada, do you have any questions to the panel?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. No questions, just to thank Dr. Flores and Tun Ben Meno for driving all the way up from INARAJAN to our capital to testify on this piece of legislation. It feels good to be back here in the public hearing room, being face to face to see that the passion that you have for the bills that come before this legislature. And I'm glad that you were able to come up to testify on this. And again, I ask the chairman to please move this legislation forward for our next our next session. Thank you again. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Ada. Senator Telo, do you have any questions on the panel before I ask you to close? I'll ask, make some statement, then I'll ask you to close.
Si Dios mase, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity. You know, I can't be more proud right now being a daughter of INALÅHAN, you know, listening to your testimonies and the testimonies of those who came before you. It's very touching. You know, we're turning a table here to change our island's name to its rightful place. And it's just, it's a great feeling to be able to do that, but I couldn't do it without the village of INALÅHAN to be here to testify. And I want to thank you, Uncle Ben, for being here and being so passionate about it. And I love the fact that you mentioned, you know, love our island, not no matter what village you're from, you know, love our island. And that's just how the people of INALÅHAN are. They don't only consider themselves, but they think of everybody. That's why people love to come to INALÅHAN to visit that village. Auntie Judy, thank you so much, Dr. Judy. You've been, I know it's very scary to come out here during this time. I didn't know if you were gonna be able to make it, but you know, I hope the people realize that you taking a chance to be here today in person says so much more than just, you know, being here, because it's still COVID is going on, but I know that this is very important to you as well. So I thank you for taking the chance to be here today, you know, I greatly appreciate it. And I don't even want to get emotional here, but biba INALÅHAN, And I'd like to close, Mr. Chair.
All right. Let me just thank the panel for being here, and then I'll ask you to close. Dr. Flores and Senor Mr. Meno, and I do expect to wrap up the committee report and hopefully get this to the for the session's consideration. If everything works right, it'll get to the floor. Thank you. Senator Telo, if you can go ahead and close, because there's no one else to testify on this bill.
Sidus Masi, Mr. Chair. And I'd like to close by just quoting again a comment made by Dr. Catherine Uggen, who in 1998 was involved with the Chamorro Heritage Institute Planning Group, wrote that decades of colonial administration and the imposition of foreign ideas and concepts have nearly obliterated our heritage and identity as people. Dr. Uggen added that we have had to discover ourselves, our thoughts and ideas, and perhaps someday we can restore all that we have lost. Mr. Chairman, although ideas such as Bill 80 may not restore all that we have lost, I am confident now more than I've ever been that when a community is seeking to be recognized in our native tongue, the impact of this bill will be much more than changing the name of a village on paper. It is my hope that Bill 60 will inspire our children and young adults to learn more about their Chamorro identity. The struggles we as a people continue to endure and the responsibilities we share in protecting the resources we have been blessed with so that future generations can forever call Guahan home. Sidus Masi, Biba Mes Chamorro and Biba Inalahan.
Thank you, Senator Telo. The committee will continue to receive testimony. Please address your written testimony to the Committee on General Government Operation, Appropriation, and Housing and submit it via email, SenatorJoeSNAugustin@gmail.com, or to my office located at Rand Care Building, second floor, suite 3, 761 South Marine Corps Drive, Tumuni, Guam. Sidus Masi for your attendance and participating in today's hearing. And for those at home, thank you for watching. The public hearing on Bill 60-36LS is now adjourned. It is now 10:33. Thank you very much for coming. My colleagues will take a 5-minute recess while they sterilize, and then we'll begin with Bill. We'll start up with Bill 7 and then Bill 56. All right? Thank you. Good morning. The Committee on General Government Operation, Appropriation, and Housing is now called back to order. Today is Wednesday, March 10. The time now is 10:40. Notice for this public hearing were disseminated, just like the first one, March 2nd, March 8th, and today is March 10th. Committee will hear and accept testimony on Bill 7-36 COR, introduced by Senator V. Antoniata, an act to add a new section 26203K38 to Chapter 26 and a new section 28106I to Chapter 28, both to Title 11, Guam Code Annotated, relative to repealing the assessment of business purpose use taxes on med equipment and telemedicine technology. I acknowledge my colleagues that have joined me today. We have the author of the bill, Senator Ada, Senator Brown, Senator Dueñas, Senator Taitague, Senator Peter Terlaje, and I know we have Senator Moylan here. With those testifying on behalf of Bill 7-36, we don't have anyone, Senator Ada, to my colleagues. But if there's any written testimony, it shall be submitted to the committee so we can provide everyone a copy. I'm just skipping a lot of the order sequence. I'd ask my colleagues that personal inference as to the character or motive of any senator or any individual testifying is not permitted. Any violation of this general rule of conduct will result in removal from the public hearing. Proper form of decorum shall be practiced by all present in the public hearing room. When you speak, please make sure that the microphone is on, that you speak into the microphone. State your name and your title for the record. I'll now ask Senator Anda to please give his opening on his bill, 7-36. Senator Anda.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you for hearing bill number 7-36. Mr. Chairman, as you know, the pandemic and the resulting restrictions on travel to and from Guam have brought to light the need to expand the availability of medical services on Guam. Telemedicine technology has made it possible for complex medical procedures to be performed regularly at remotely located hospitals without the cost to patient or physician travel, provided that the remote hospital has the proper equipment. Most private hospitals and clinics buy medical equipment directly from the manufacturer, so they are assessed a use tax instead of BPT. Resellers of medical equipment for Government of Guam healthcare agencies are exempt from the BPT for such sales. A private clinic or hospital that invests $2 million in equipment to outfit a new cath lab would have to pay $80,000 in use taxes once the equipment lands on Guam. Additionally, the facility would have to pay for accreditation, installation, and preventive maintenance costs. Mr. Chair, a cath lab is the venue where certain heart attack patients go to receive life-saving stents in their coronary arteries. Without cath labs or insurance coverage for limited Guam facilities, patients must be stabilized with dangerous blood-thinning drugs and then sent to hospitals off-island in Manila, Honolulu, or California for the procedure. Guam's healthcare system needs to continue working on bringing quality medical care to our island. Each year, we send tens of millions of healthcare insurance, Medicare, Medicaid, and MIP dollars to hospitals outside of Guam. Our residents collectively spend millions on airfare and hotel rooms to get off-island medical care. More local procedure means increasing Guam's tax base, as well as providing good jobs for healthcare professionals. This bill will provide a small incentive to get our hospital and private clinics to invest in new technology and reduce the number of off-island referrals just for basic medical care. Again, Mr. Chairman, I thank you for having this hearing on Bill 736, and I ask my colleagues for their support. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator. Does any of the colleagues like to speak? Senator Brown, we'll begin with you, ma'am, if you have anything you wanted to state in reference to this bill.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I don't really have much to add other than what Senator Ada has already brought forth, and certainly supportive of his initiative. I think certainly after all the things we've experienced, particularly during this past year, I think we see the benefits of what we will gain with regards to the medical services that can be provided by this equipment, and I certainly support his initiative with regards to this bill. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, for the opportunity to comment.
Thank you. Senator Pito, do you have any comments you want to present?
First off, thank you, Mr. Chair, and I just want to congratulate the author of the bill. This is a very good bill, and I rise in support of bill number 736, and I want to thank the author for putting this out, because this is a long time due type of bill, and it's a good bill, and I support the bill. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, sir. Senator Moylan, do you have any questions or any comments you'd like to make?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm also in support of this bill. I'm glad the measure was introduced. I think it's very helpful, and we are addressing critical needs for the health of our community. So I thank the author of the bill. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Telo.
Sidus Masi, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity to speak on Bill 7-36. This is very similar to something that we were looking at during the 35th Guam legislature regarding these incentives are these tax breaks for medical equipment and telemedicine technology. I think it's something that the senators should really consider and support this measure because of the importance, especially in the circumstances that we are in today. I was hoping that somebody from BBMR, Reverend Tax, would be here to discuss any kind of what information is available from Reverend Taxation or Customs and Quarantine on the volume and value of medical equipment, technology, just giving us some inside information with regards to the any kind of financial loss. But the loss is very minimal considering what it's going to do and help our community. And the push on especially most needed equipment in as we face this crisis right now, this health crisis on this island. But it's a bill that is desperately needed, so I ask the chairman to please expedite this as expeditiously as possible so that we can move forward and voting in support of this measure. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Telo. Senator Dueñas, do you have any questions or comments?
Sidus Masi, Mr. Chairman, no questions, but just a couple of comments. First of all, I would like to thank my good colleague, Senator Ada, for introducing this valuable bill. And as much of my other, much like what most of my other colleagues have been saying, that this is a good bill. And, you know, Mr. Chairman, I think this bill is one of those that's a forward-thinking bill. As the, author of the bill said, you know, as we grow on Guam, and you know, we know that we have our regional brothers and sisters that come to Guam for healthcare. We're talking about building a new hospital. I'm sure that I know that GRMC, although it's been somewhat stalled, there's a medical arts building that's being was under construction and probably will see itself finished out soon. And so as the specialties start to develop and as we grow in the healthcare community here, I agree with the author of the bill that any little incentives that we can give to make sure that this sophisticated equipment coming to Guam to serve our population, to keep our people here as much as possible, to start to receive someday down the line more state-of-the-art medicine is a much higher payoff than any possible offsets that that this bill could perhaps cause in terms of business privilege tax. And so I think that once again, you might not see a whole bunch of write-offs this year with regard to this bill, but certainly as we grow in our healthcare system and in our medical community, there will be those offsets. And Mr. Chairman, I think that anything that we can do, sometimes even if it's just a little bit, it may make the difference, as the author said, whether or not they bring out some of those other highly sophisticated medical equipment that can save lives here, keep our people here, keep their airplane ticket money, their food money, their hotel money, and like I said, even our regional brothers and sisters that come to Guam maybe to to seek care here, to spend their dollars here as well. I think that this is one of those bills that that does that, incentivizes opportunities to take care of our people. So I thank the author, and I certainly support this bill wholeheartedly. Suzumasi, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Dueñas. Senator, before you close, I want to make a few comments for my colleagues. Just a reminder, you do all have a copy of the BBMR's fiscal note and the OFB's note. And the main emphasis that they put on is that understand that we don't know what the impact may be. That being said, be mindful when we do get to the budget that we don't try to stress that there's going to be money here, because the money will be gone. I support the intent of the bill. It has very good intentions. There's no doubt about that. But just understand, when we get to the budget portion, the overall budget, we don't be looking at these areas on the GRT. Try to just turn away when you look at that section and start focusing on everything else, because this is an unknown territory. I would really hope that the practice of medicine in Guam will increase, improve, more beds, more machines, upgraded machines, and so forth. And with that note, Senator Adda, go ahead and proceed to close. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, for your comments. And you know, when we look at the overall picture of medical technology and our local healthcare system, I think that we need to ensure that we can provide all that is available to our people without traveling off island. I understand the thought of possible impacts to the use tax or things like that, but I think the greater good of our health for our people, especially those who have that can't afford to go off island, that need the medical care here on our island, that's who we work to protect, and those are the ones that we help to ensure that they can get the basic medical needs and health care right here on our island. And I hope that, Mr. Chair, you'll be able to move this bill forward so that we may be able to vote on it in our next session. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for your comments, and thank you to my colleagues for their support.
Thank you, sir. That being said, the committee will continue to receive testimonies, and please address, if there's any testimony out there within the public, the people of Guam, please address your written testimony to the Committee on General Government Operation, Appropriation, and Housing, and submit it via email to Senator Joe S. Augustine at gmail.com, or to my office located at Rand Care Building, second floor, Suite 3, 761 South Marine Corps Drive, Tumuning, Guam. Jesus Masi, for your attendance and participation in today's hearing. And for those at home, thank you for watching. This public hearing on Bill 7-36, COR, is now adjourned. It is now 10:54. Thank you. We will now proceed on now to Bill 56-36, and we have one that is assigned in to testify, and that's Mr. Dominic Hernandez. Will I have my staff please ask the gentleman to proceed, come in? Oh, Mr. Hernandez left. He had to take care of something. So the Committee on General Government Operation and Appropriation will continue on this hearing, and we will hear Bill 56-36, and all rules still stand in place. Mr. Hernandez is not available. He left. And I'll ask Senator Moylan, if you can please give your opening, and maybe we can all discuss this bill. Thank you. Senator Moylan.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Bill 5636 is an act to add subsection 6110D to Chapter 6, Title 3, Guam Code Annotated, relative to requiring the submittal of a drug test by those seeking an elected public office. As we know, the elected position is a trusted position by the public. And presently, we do have some requirements. We need to submit a Guam Police Report, the Judiciary of Guam certification, as well as a history with any legal matters. We also must sign an affidavit that we have not been convicted of a felony or a crime involving moral turpitude or criminal sexual conduct. But we do know that we have a rising drug-related cases on island. So it's, I believe it's important that our electorate get the assurance when seeking our trust, when they go into the voting booths, toward these elected officials having a drug-free lifestyle. Because as elected officials, we know that we play a major role against illegal substances. And it's vital that our position not conflict with any drug usage. And instead, we had to make the tough decisions to reduce the presence of such substance on our island. So I want to thank you, Mr. Chairman, for the opportunity to have this public hearing on this bill. And I'm looking forward to any questions. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Senator Peter Terlaje, do you have any comments or questions?
I just want to, you know, this bill requires that if you're seeking office, public office, you know, you have to go get tested. And if the test procedures would involve sticking that needle in my arm, then I would go against this bill. But as of right now, with the testing process, I think I support and I stand in support of 5636. My only qualm to this is that, you know, if one is going to seek elected public office and then lost the election, then, you know, that person is going to be spending like $40 and even more for the testing. But I stand in support of this bill. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Senator Brown.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I mean, I don't have an issue with regards to taking a drug test. I mean, I think the reality of being in public life, and certainly some of us have been in public life for many, many years, you know, I think this is a non-issue with regards to that. But I do want to point out a few issues. Now, while I understand certainly the intent of our author, Senator Moylan, is to ensure that elected officials set that example. Because I am concerned about the bigger issues right now happening in the government of Guam, where we have, for the last couple of years, at least from the information I've been hearing, there's been less and less actual drug testing. And while I understand it can be argued with the Attorney General's position that, you know, non-designated positions, unless there's evidence that might lead management to determine that an employee should be tested, you know, you just can't go testing administrative employees. But the concern I have is that designated employee positions in our government may have not been tested over the last couple of years. And that concerns me even greater because of the direct impact that can have on our community. Having been the Director of Public Works for a couple of years, I did experience, Mr. Chair, where I did have bus drivers. And unfortunately, in some cases, only because an accident or an incident happened that required a testing of that situation, that we ended up finding out that we had some bus drivers, unfortunately, again, it's, thank goodness it's a smaller percentage, that were on crystal methamphetamine, that were driving our children around. We have people in designated employee, you know, employee positions that are responsible for ensuring safety, are working with heavy equipment and things that can, where they can be a danger to themselves or even more importantly, a danger to others. I'm very concerned about what I'm seeing as the erosion of responsibility in our government with regards to the issue of drug use, particularly at a time, Mr. Chairman, when we are seeing a growing problem in our own community of drug abuse. That bothers me more than anything else, especially because it leads to all the other issues and crimes that are happening here in our community. And I think that's a bigger issue that we also need to look at. So if the Attorney General has opined that it's really more so the designated positions, the fact that that is not, at least I don't see evidence of it, that we're starting to see proliferation of other problems that have been created as a result of that in our government, I think we also need to address that. I don't know if we need to mandate that those drug tests happen in designated positions. But I think we need to set a higher standard. I have no problem being in an elected capacity of taking a drug test. But I think we need to ensure that our public officials, and that includes everyone that gets a paycheck from the people of Guam, also are responsible individuals in this community that are also setting the standard and setting the better example. Because it's creating a bigger problem out there in our community, and I don't think, and I don't hear, and I don't see to the degree that we're dealing with that.
Nowadays, it's almost anything goes. Let's roll out the red carpet for the criminals. And that, to me, is very bothersome. One of the things I don't agree with in the draft of this bill is the issue with regards to medical marijuana, and that is not going to be a portion of this test that's going to be required. Because if you are in a designated position, even though cannabis has been legalized, again, without consensus of the people, because this issue didn't go before the people of Guam to vote on. We had them vote on medical marijuana, but when it came to legalizing marijuana, that issue was not put before the people. So I'm not so casual about this issue. Maybe we should put, alcohol test levels. Why don't we just add that to the list as well to make sure that our public officials are all coherent all around? But I definitely object to removing cannabis from this test. Because of our law enforcement people and designated positions in this government must meet, they can't have this in their system. At least the last time I checked. I don't think they're allowed to have anything in their system to the degree that can impact their ability to properly execute their job. So I'm not so casual about this issue, especially as I continue to see the issues, the impacts, the crime in our community, the fear that our people are experiencing, especially our elderly, Mr. Chairman. Are people not feeling safe in their own homes? And our leadership is not setting that standard and setting that example in terms of how we go about ensuring accountability and responsibility in our government. So I certainly have no problem complying with this requirement, should I run again or if I'm required to do it now in my current capacity. But I will object to excluding cannabis or tests for marijuana in our systems as well, because I'm sorry, if we expect law enforcement and others in designated positions in this government to meet the standard where they don't have these type of drugs in their system, then by all means, we as elected officials should not either. If we're going to go down this road, then by all means, let's make sure that we're upright citizens in this community and that we're being responsible. Certainly, sorry, Mr. Chairman, I don't know if I should apologize. I guess I'm not going to apologize with regards to this. I have no objection to this bill, but I'm going to also say let's deal with the bigger issue in this government and let's deal with the bigger issues in this community that are being harmed by drugs. And I think we should expect the same thing of our staff here at the Guam Legislature. If the Attorney General is opining that we cannot test the rest of our employees unless we determine there's a cause for that, then I don't even know how we are requiring at the point of employment that every government employee has to submit to a drug test. I think those issues need to be brought forth and further determined. But I think we must set the example, but we also have to ensure the rest of the government of Guam is setting an example as well. Because when these things are harming our communities, when they're harming our families, when they're harming our ability to live safely in this community, feel comfortable in our own homes, feel comfortable to even let our children out in the yard to play, then I think we need to deal with that bigger issue because that is the bigger issue. This is only one component of that. Because otherwise, we're just going through the motions and we're turning a blind eye to the bigger issues that are harming our people. So I certainly will support this bill that Senator Moylan has introduced, but by all means, I will not support it with the removal of the marijuana provision. I think that needs to be included. And I think hopefully with ensuring better standards and higher standards in our government that we set a better example for our community. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, for the opportunity to comment on this bill.
Thank you, Senator Brown. Senator Dueñas. Do you have any comments on this bill?
Sidus Masi, Mr. Chairman. Yes, I have a couple of comments, and I want to thank the author, my good colleague, Senator Jim Moylan, for the introduction of this bill. Mr. Chairman, when there was questions several weeks back about the legislature's position on oversight hearings and other discussions about issues facing our government and substance abuse and other issues with regard to employment. First of all, when I was fortunate to you know, get a seat in this 36th Guam legislature, and I brought my staff on board. I made it clear that our office would be a drug-free workplace. And I made it clear that we would have random testing within my office, starting with myself. One thing I did mention to my staff, and I did this in a release when my staff and I all went down a couple weeks back and took a drug test. It was a screening for all substances. But I also made it clear to my staff that if you have any type of an issue with any substance abuse, come to me and I will ensure that I help you get the help that you need, work with whatever authorities, mental health and substance abuse, whatever nonprofits are out there, whatever treatment regimen you seek, and we'll get you through this. Let me know and disclose to me, because I think it's important, and I didn't see this earlier as an opportunity to share, but I want to share this because, you know, some people always have a tendency sometimes to misrepresent when individuals take a conservative stance, a zero tolerance type stance, and say, oh, you know, those individuals don't have a heart. They don't give second chances. They're not second chance people. It's not true, Mr. Chairman. It's not true at all. I think a lot of us are very, very, you know, aware that a lot of individuals who've worked very hard, who try to do the best in their life, always count on the first chance. But I am a second chance person. And I am a person who was very committed to my staff, and as I have in other government positions. And if you come to me and let me know that you're struggling with this in your life, I will get you the help that you need. Because I think that's who we are as a people. But going back to the intent of this bill, I will always and any time, as a public servant, being paid by the hard-earned tax dollars of our people, stand before them to be counted on what I believe should be a drug-free workplace when we are being paid by the taxpayers of Guam. So those are just my feelings, Mr. Chairman. But I think I would dare speak for everybody in this body, because I know everybody pretty much on a personal level, or at least a professional level. We are not cold-hearted people. We will help our people, but we're also very cognizant of the fact that tax dollars are precious, they're limited, and when you take somebody else's hard-earned money to provide services to the people of Guam and to be the beneficiary of being employed by the people of Guam, because that's who the boss is, really, the people of Guam, then I think that our standards should be such that we would submit to this, and I think that no less should be expected. On the issue of cannabis, I'm going to have to remain open. Like I said, I'm very conservative, but I want to hear the discussion on that as it goes further. Those are the comments that I have for now. Once again, and I do support the bill. I will be voting for the bill when it reaches the floor, pending any any other difficulties attached to it, but as it reads, I'm in support of the bill. So just must say, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Dueñas. Senator Adams, do you have any comments or statements?
Thank you, Mr. Chair, and thank you to my colleagues for their comments as well. I'm in support of this legislation, and I hope that the comments that were presented by my colleague, Senator Brown, are also taken into consideration in moving forward. Perhaps if not an improvement in this piece of legislation, then perhaps future legislations to address the issues that she did bring up. And yes, we are all accountable. We are all held accountable. And that's what we need to be, is accountable to the people of Guam who put us and elected us to these offices, but also holding all those that hold leadership positions, be it directors, administrators, and anyone else that works for our government, accountable to the same standards as well. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Adams. Senator Telo.
Situs Masi, Mr. Chair, for the opportunity to speak on Bill 56-36. I appreciated the comments made by my colleagues and recommendations as well to this. You know, I did have some questions. I was hoping the Guam Election Commission would be here today to testify on this legislation because, you know, we're requiring them to do this piece of this mandate if the bill should become law. But, you know, as written, I have to ask myself if Bill 56 automatically disqualifies a candidate from seeking public office after he or she submits a positive result for illegal substance. Does it automatically say they're disqualified? You know, I'd hate to think that this bill would be just for show, you know, and doesn't have any real teeth, which is another concern in this legislation. Where are the teeth in this bill? Also, as an alternative, you know, to having an individual determine whether he or she will take a drug test, is the Guam Election Commission in a position legally to conduct random drug screening at any time between the filing of the candidacy and the certification of the candidacy? I think if anybody is going to take a drug test knowingly when they're going to take one, I mean, that defeats its purpose of even having a drug test. So I think there's some concerns in this legislation, if we are really looking at, you know, being accountable. Without the Guam Election Commission's testimony, you know, I really think that they should chime into this. And I hope, Mr. Chair, that I'm pretty sure your office did call them to be here to testify today. But I do stand in full support of drug testing, random drug testing. Not one where, you know, you're asked to give a drug test when you have some time, free time in the next, you know, couple weeks. And I hear there are mechanisms in which you can take or what they call a washout, you know, so that there's nothing detected when you do take this test. So I think this legislation should have some teeth to it. And again, I do stand in support of random drug testing for our community, I mean, for our government of Guam. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Taitague. Before I ask Senator Moylan to close on his bill, number one, I'm in support of, you wanna run for office, get tested. And it should be consistent with what one of my colleagues brought up. You wanna be employed by Gov Guam, get tested. Whatever the requirement for testing for employment should be no different when you're being tested for elected office or any elected official. And maybe I will sit down with the author and communicate with the Election Commission so that the mechanisms is in place so that it is coordinated the way it needs to be coordinated, just like employment. It's not the individual that goes to the lab and says, hey, I need to be tested. It needs to be coordinated. It needs to be, this all has to be coordinated. And then on the next issue, I do hope that maybe my colleagues and maybe my office will work with any of the colleagues present, that maybe we can establish a reasonable and a more sensible definition of the word random. Being former retired military, there is a mechanism of random. It does not conflict with the AG's opinion or legal opinion of the intrusion or unreasonable search. There's a way they do the random. Senator Moylan is aware of that, and Senator Terlaje is aware of that, how they set it up. And once we can get to that point, I think when we sit down and we work out how the military does their random, you don't get to run away. You don't get a chance to wash out. You don't even know when you're going to get tested until they tell you that day you show up for work. Step in the room, you're being tested, period. And then that's where we can make the system work. And like my colleague brought up, I'm concerned about Gov Guam employees. I'm concerned even about my staff, if any of them. When I say I'm concerned is that if we're going to start the random, we do it across the board for everyone. No stone should be left unturned. With that, Senator Moylan, if you could close on your bill. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, colleagues, for the discussion on the bill. It is really interesting and definitely something to consider as we move forward. Starting from the top, we as elected officials, policymakers, by leading by example, and that's one of the reasons this bill came about. I did take a sample myself just to test the procedure and how that worked. It cost me $25. I don't particularly like needles either, but all I had to do is stand up and face the urinal and then turn it over to the examiner, so that was easy and painless. The total cost, really, for what we look at as the other reports that we know we had to submit, different court clearances, and these court clearances also had to come with a date. I remember not turning mine in properly, and because it was, I think it was after 30 days, I had to go get another one. So it's something I think the Guam Election Commission, I'm sure they'll be able to provide us testimony with, that can be easily tracked by adding one more procedure with some drug testing. Just submitting the report at that. I think the teeth on this measure is there, and basically what it would already pre-exist. If an elected official signs an affidavit, but there is, based on some reports or their admittance of crime involving moral turpitude or criminal sexual conduct, too bad, so sad. You're not going to be an elected official then. So no matter what it says on your other court reports or your police clearance or anything like that. So that's the teeth of the existing law. And it will apply likewise to just this testing too. But the real test of this is the electorate. This bill does not say you can't run for office. Not at all. It just says show us your reports. It's up to the electorate to decide if you should run or not. That's based on when they get in the voting booth. So that's the purpose of this. And I think what like we said in the introduction of this bill, it's about public trust. And if your different court clearances tell all these different crimes that you may have done in the past, then that's available for the public to review. If your police report says, you know, you're not such a great driver and you've got all these speeding tickets, that's something the public can review too. And why not let the public review if you have any drug issues as well? And this is just a start. As my colleague has mentioned, we need to do this throughout the government of Guam. We need to, it's not only just the elected officials, right? It's the one that's driving the bus. It's the one that is doing your paperwork. All our things are really important. We all hold a position in government that is the trust of the people. And I'm hoping that as we move this legislature forward with other amendments that we possibly would see on the floor to strengthen it, then let's do so. So I want to thank my colleagues for the discussion, and I look forward to moving the bill onto the session floor. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much, colleagues.
Thank you, Senator Moylan. This committee will conclude this public hearing. The committee will continue to receive testimony for a few more days. Please address your written testimony to the Committee on General Government Operation, Appropriation, and Housing, submitted via email to Senator Joe S. San Agustin at gmail.com or to my office located at Rand Care Building, second floor, suite 3, 761 South Marine Corps Drive, Tumuning, Guam. Sizus Masi for your attendance and participation in today's hearing. And for those at home, thank you for watching. This public hearing is on Bill 56-36, is now adjourned. Sizus Masi, please be safe. Thank you.